Hello, welcome to my channel. My name's Ashley, and today I'm going to be doing a story time about the time my hair got all messed up. Basically, I had a straight line put in my hair. So, first I'm going to start off by making a disclaimer by saying that I'm not meaning to, be mean, but what I experienced during this experience was not the best. And I know that there's different generations of different hairstylists. I strongly believe that there are. This just wasn't what I expected at all, and the way that the hairstylist went about it as well. Yeah. So to begin this story, I was, I think, in my junior year of high school, and I had purple in my hair for a long time. I had bleached about, my hair was really long. It was probably about, I don't know if you can see that, down to here or a little bit longer. And I had bleached the ends to way too much. And I had dyed those purple. So that was really the only hair experience that I had prior to this. I wanted to get a balayage done. That's what I wanted done. And there was this girl that I worked with at the time who had blonde hair that looked really natural, and she just had the prettiest hair. She still does. We'll call the salon that she went to Salon A. I'm not going to use the real names just because. But she went to Salon A, and what Salon A was it was in the back kind of this other store. I think that the wife owned the salon part and then the husband owned the outer store part. So there wasn't an actual sign that said Salon A. You had to go into this place, which was in the back. That's what it was. So it was really hard to find. She had really nice hair, so like I said, I wanted to get something done too. So that's where I was gonna go because she said it was really good. I googled the name, and that Salon A came up on the Google page, and then it had its address and its phone number to call and stuff. So I called this number, and whenever the person answered, they said, I'm gonna use a different name too, but when they answered, they said, hair company, how can I help you? And that should have been my first tip off that something wasn't right. But I didn't think about it because I just didn't think about it. I don't know why I didn't. So I thought that that was a little bit weird. I asked them also, I said, is this Salon A? Is this the same place? And they were yeah, it's the same place. What would you like to have done? So I told them and I made my appointment and everything was fine. I thought that I was going to Salon A to get a balayage done. So whenever I get to the hair place, I used the address that Google said was Salon A, and whenever I got there, it said hair company on the top, the name of the place that they said that they were. So I was like, okay, this is a little weird. Also, it was its own building and had its own name and everything like that, which was also weird because she said that it was in the back of a building for the other one. So I was just like, okay, this is a little weird, but it's fine. Everybody knows how to do everything pretty much. It's gonna be okay. It's all gonna be good is what I thought. I went in and it's this older lady and she has really pretty hair and she was really, really nice at first. She was nice. And I said to her, as I was sitting in the chair, I was like, yeah, I just want a balayage done. And this was around the time when I think balayage was something kind of new. I don't know if it's always been around or not, but it was just more becoming heard of, I guess. And so I said that. I was just like, I want a balayage. And she says to me, what's that? So I knew at this point that I had messed up. I should have checked to make sure I was going to the right place. Ugh, it's really not that big of a deal, but it was to me. She's just like, what's a balayage? And I was like, it's like, I explained it to her. I was like, I think it's like an ombre, because I still wasn't completely sure, but I kind of knew. I was like, it's an ombre that like has highlights up into your hair. Simple, not really, but yeah, that's just what I said. And she was like, oh, okay, like, we can do that. So she starts doing my hair. She does like the foils and everything. And we were just talking like how you normally talk whenever you go to the hair place. And I noticed that she was kind of like talking crap about Salon A, which was the salon that I thought that I was going to. I think I mentioned something about like that's where I thought I was. And that's when she proceeded to tell me, no, like, that's the salon next door. Like, they always steal my customers, which makes no sense if it was hard to find the number. Like, if the number for that salon came up to be this one, like, I don't know. She was also saying that Salon A was stealing a bunch of her workers, that nobody wanted to work at the hair company, which was where I was. They wanted to go to Salon A instead, which is kind of tips you off a little bit too, because if the people don't like working there, then like, why should I go there? Like, I don't know. So like, she's doing my hair, it's all fine, everything's going okay. Like, it, like I said, at this point I didn't know that much about hair, like, as much as I do now. Like, I'm in no way a hairdresser or anything. Like, I've just seen stuff on YouTube, so I pretty much know nothing about hair, but I just know a little bit more than I did at this point in time. I'm sitting under the hair dryer, and whenever she comes to check over on my hair, I can tell that she kind of has like a concerned look on her face. And I was like, is everything okay? Like, what's wrong? What's happening? I can see, like, out of the, like, corner of my eye when she pulls back the foil, like, my hair is bright orange. And I know that everybody has brassy undertones in their hair, like, nobody just goes straight to, like, ashy or, like, a cool tone, like, kind of blonde or anything like that. But my hair was, like, bright orange, like, seriously, like, highlighter orange. And that's probably because I, like, bleached it and, like, dyed it a bunch of times before that, so that was my own fault. But I was just a little bit shocked. I was like, oh, like, what are we gonna do? Like, I don't want my hair to be orange at all. She says to me that she's gonna put in a toner and it would tone down that orange a little bit, so it would be more of a neutral blonde, because at this point I didn't want like a bright blonde by any means. Like, I wanted it to look really natural, and I didn't want a bright blonde at all. Like, I was really nervous about that. I didn't want a light blonde, I just wanted it natural, like I said, like a dirty blonde, something like that. She told me we'll tone it down a little bit, and like, I want to stress to like tone it down a little bit, because like, we'll get to that later. So after that, she rinsed out my hair and like everything was going fine. I thought, she was like, yeah, like, it looks really pretty, like, it looks really good. So I wasn't concerned at all, because obviously she knows everything, and like, I didn't know much at that time. So I was like, okay, it's fine, like, everything's going good. It was when she sat me back down in the chair and started blow drying my hair and combing it through and putting the products in and stuff, that it looked like there was a like line in my hair, which like, everybody knows like the comical like line being in a hair from like a balayage. But I was like, oh, like, okay, like, this is fine, really, I don't care that much. Like, I thought that it was gonna be okay. So after she dried it, it was like really noticeable that there was just a straight like line in my hair. And she kept reassuring me. She kept saying like, it's really pretty, I can curl it for you, like, it's really, really pretty. I know now that she like curled it so that you probably wouldn't be able to notice the line that much, but I just had her curl it anyways. And I was like, whatever, like, what's done is done. After I paid, and whenever I went out into my car, like, I just started crying. I looked in the mirror, like, of my car, and the bottom of my hair was like white. Like, I guess at this point, like, I wouldn't really like mind having it now, like, if it was blended okay, but like, the bottom of my hair was white. Like, my hair had never been that light before. It like looked bleach blonde kind of, but just like really white, and the top of my hair was dark at the time. Like, she didn't lighten that or anything. It was like a stark contrast, and my hair was longer than it is now, but it It was bad. And like at this point in my life, my hair meant everything to me. Like it still like means a lot to me. That was back whenever I cared a lot more about what people thought about me and like how I looked. So like if my hair didn't look good, then I didn't look good in general, I thought. So since my hair looked like this, I was like, oh my gosh, like I'm ugly. My hair looks like crap. Like I am not gonna be able to look good to anybody. I was just so concerned about it. And then at that point in time, I never curled my hair really. I just straightened my hair all the time. And so the next day, I straightened my hair, and then I had my sister take a picture of the back of my hair so that I would know what it looked like. This is what my hair looked like. It's really not that big of a deal. Like, I know that I'm probably just sounding like I'm some high maintenance, like my hair has to be pretty all the time. But like at that point, like I was so upset and so sad about how bad my hair looked because I never wanted a line in my hair. Like I wanted this pretty, like blended out look that looked natural, but it was like everything but that. And it just was so stressful to me because, like I said, my hair meant everything to me. I got my hair done on a Friday. And then that next Monday, I called back and said, can you fix my hair? Like, I don't want it to look like this. She like basically told me like, yeah, you can, but like you have to pay like more money. You have to pay more money for it to be fixed. And at that point I was just like, no, like I'm not gonna do it. And I had this other girl who I was friends with at the time like fix it because she's really good at hair. But yeah, that was the story of the time my hair got ruined in a way. Like I said, I'm not meaning to shame that lady because I'm sure she knew what she was doing. Like with other things, I just like didn't really appreciate how she acted like she knew what she was doing, but she really didn't. And it's all fine now. Like I have a great hair lady now. Like she's actually one of my friends. But yeah, that was just stressful for me. It was a stressful time. Thank you for watching my video and listening to me rant a little bit for however long of time. If you like this video, maybe subscribe. You don't have to if you don't want to. I don't know how often I'll be making videos, but thank you so much for watching, and hopefully I will have more videos for you soon.